So we will start today evaluatory method and design of the study. Method clearly describe how you are going to start your research. Retrospective, prospective, treatment allocation, how you allocate the treatment, parallel design, crossover study in these two groups is made, evaluate control, blinding, mixing the patients, random allocation to whom you are going to give the medicine without any specific solution. How you use the placebo. Placebo is a tablet which has no active ingredient. Then you compare the two groups, evaluate method analysis, how you will evaluate your patients. This is all about what we were discussing, clinical study, right? Then drug safety information communication, FDA. We have to inform to the Federal Drug Agency of the United States. Timely communication of the important drug safety information provides healthcare professionals, patients, consumers, and other interested persons with access to the most current information concerning the potential risk and benefit of the marketed drug. Means once you have marketed the drug, introduced into the market that drug, which has been gone through phase one, phase two trial. In phase one trial, we just go for the pharmacokinetics and dynamics of the product on healthy volunteers. In phase two, we select the minimum number of patients, single hospital, and give in a real condition, that is they are patients who have got disease. Then we go for multiple hospitals and number of patients are more than 5,000 in different part of the country. And then we observe the result of this drug on those patients. This is phase three trial. Phase four trial, you launch the product in the market and we call it SAM study, safety assessment of marketed medicine. And then we allocate through the FDA to certain hospitals to inform any adverse effect having on patient during the treatment. If the adverse effect is more than the desirable, then we have to stop the medicine and withdraw from the market and go for investigation why this side effect has been happening. So we observe the risk and benefit of marketed drugs, not marketed, which is already present in the market. Helping them, this is a phase four trial, helping them to make more informed treatment choices. So we gave more choices to the doctor to treat their patient. Background, all drugs have risk and health. Care professionals must balance the risk and benefit of a drug therapy when making decision about whether to use the drug. Means doctor has to not only to see the benefit of the drug, but also the side effect of the drug. If the risk is higher, then withdraw the drug. Don't give this drug to the patient. If the benefit is higher side, then give that drug and take little risk. The general risk and benefit of a drug therapy are described in the product prescribing information. If you take out a leaf insert from a bottle of a drug, you'll find the prescription information. And in that, all the adverse and side effects are given over there. So doctor, a physician, and pharmacist has to go through both prescription inserts. FDA provides information on drug risk and benefit to healthcare professionals and patients when that information has generated a specific concern has prompted a regulatory action such as revision to the drug prescribing information. If you find something wrong, then you have to go through and investigate and change your leaf inserts or prescription information and provide to the physicians. Example of important drug safety issues includes, but are not limited, serious adverse effect, ADR, identified after drug approval, medication error, which includes, but are not limited, confusion between the drug name and confusion regarding drug labeling. Maybe the labels are wrong or name is wrong. These may lead to improper use of the drugs, the prescribing or administrating an improper dose. If wrong dose is given on the label, then it will be harmful for the patient, and we have to go for the safety of the patient. To a patient taking another medication with which the drug interacts, and if already patient is taking certain medicines, like in diabetes and hypertension, he has got two diseases, hypertension, diabetes, or peripheral neuropathy, then he is taking 2-3 drugs at a time. Maybe diuretics, beta blocker, calcium channel blocker, vasodilator, right? An oral hypoglycemic agent or injectable insulin. So we have to take care that drug interaction should not be happening. FDA may decide to issue a public health alert or a press release about a medical product or hold a media briefing to communicate important disinformation. Once in 2002, I think, we have launched one of the products, Valdecoxib, which is COX-2 inhibitor in Pakistan. And when I was in Dadu, I have received a message from the head office that please withdraw that drug and inform to all distributors to return that drug to the company. Because last night, CNN has announced through information of the FDA that they communicate important risk information of this drug. So we withdraw the drug from the market, and we do not allow anyone to use that drug which has been declared as a unsafe or risky drug. When does FDA communicate emerging drug safety information to the public? FDA considered many factors in deciding whether emerging drug safety information should be made available to the public. These factors may include, but are not limited to, the following: seriousness of the events, how severe the side effect, for example, severity and reversibility. If it is severe and cannot use it, you are not able to save the life of a patient, or this side effect is reversible with your treatment, emergency treatment, relative to the benefit of treatment. Though the benefit of that drug is very good, but that drug is causing severe side effects also, which is harmful for the patient. Magnitude of the risk, likelihood of occurrence, kitni dafa ho raha hai, how many times this risk is happening, or the side effect is happening. Strengthening of the evidence of casual relationship between the use of a drug and the adverse effect. So you have to match the effectiveness of the drug and the adverse events happening with that drug. Extent of patient exposure, for example, how broadly the drug is used. So we have to see how many times this drug is used by the patient, and the risk, how much risk is there. This proportionate impact on particular population, for example, children or elderly, they are the very sensitive patients. Patient for preventing or mitigating the risk in a patient population, for example, by monitoring patient selection or avoiding the concomitant treatment. This is the duty of a physician, pharmacist, and nurse to take care of the patient. How many medicines patients are taking, and before starting the treatment, how many drugs he has been in this treatment. And availability of alternative therapies. If this drug is not working, then how you can replace this drugs with other drugs. How does FDA communicate important drug safety information to the public? FDA has created effective and ongoing relationship with a wide array of trade and professional associations. Means the FDA has a contact with the physician and professionals to inform time to time any adverse effect they observe in the market, to inform to the concerned professionals and give them alerts. Patient advocacy and consumer group. There are certain patients are selected to inform any adverse effect, and consumer groups are there who take care of the patient. If they found anything wrong with the patient, they inform to the FDA. safety organizations are there, media can inform, and other entities. Tool and method to communicate drug safety information to the public, how they will be informed to the public. FDA approved prescription information, that is drug labeling, drug safety communication, DSC, a post-market communication tool. Post-market means once you have marketed the drug into the market. What is FDA approval labeling? The label on the drug should be approved according to the FDA standards. FDA approved prescribing information for healthcare professionals and patients, packing, inserts, and medication guide for patients is the primary source of established information. This insert of the or package inside the drug will give you basic information, first information about a drug safety and efficacy. It summarizes the essential scientific information needed for the safe and effective use of the drug. How to use the drug before meal, after meal, with water, with milk, empty stomach, full stomach. This is all information is given on that prescription information inside. So this is FDA approval labeling. Patient focus information, patient labeling could help prevent serious side effects. If the patient even go through those leave inserts or leave package, he can save himself that, because it's mentioned over there what are the side effects, and if you feel any side effect, you can withdraw the drug. A drug product has serious risk in related to the benefit of which patients should be made aware, because information concerning the risk and could affect a patient's decision to use or to continue use the product. So if patient is informed before that these are the side effects or adverse effects of this drug, and if you feel any such side effects or adverse effects, please withdraw or discontinue this drug or inform to your physician. A drug product is important to health and patient adherence, so the direction for use is crucial to the drug's effectiveness. So drug is necessary for the health purpose, to treat the patient and bring him into the healthy, and patient adherence to the direction means patient has to follow the direction given in the approval label of the FDA. In that way, there is less chances of the risk or side effects. What is the drug safety and communication? A drug safety communication is a specific tool used by the FDA to communicate to the public important information about safety issues, including emerging safety information about marketed drugs. DSC generally communicate the following information: a summary of the safety issues and the nature of the risk being communicated. The established benefit or benefit of the drug being discussed. Recommended actors for health care professionals and patients when appropriate. So whenever it is needed, we have to inform to the physician, professionals, and patient as well as. A summary of the data reviewed or being reviewed by FDA. FDA have to review these information time to time. If there is any change, any information they receive, they should modify it according to the need of the patient with the time, changing time. So as the time will change, they have to follow the review of this information and find out if anything can be changed, should be changed, and informed to the concerned professional, patient, and any other group. So this topic, our topic was the evaluating a clinical stage. This one I'm talking about means we, before launching any drug in the market, we have to consider a lot of things. Means first of all, we have to consider the FDA approval information, and then we apply on our daily practice. And because FDA allow any drug in the market, after certain trials of this drug, we find out the risk and safety and benefit of this drug. So first clinical trial is taking place, which we call it phase one trial, on patients. Volunteers. And these volunteers are between the 14 and 24 in number. They are all healthy individuals. We just give one dose of that drug, single dose of that drug, and then we take a blood sample after a certain period of time, after 3-4 hours, and then we see the availability of the drug in the body. We call it bioavailability, the concentration of the drug in the serum. This is only the first phase trial, phase one trial. And we have to find out the pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics of the drug. In second phase, we go through a small number of patients, maybe 100 to 100, 500, in one hospital only, not many hospitals. And then we observe the recovery of that patient with this drug. If you find a positive response, then we go for the phase three clinical trial, and that happened in multiple hospitals and more than 5,000 patients. If the result is favorable, then we go through certain courses, means we submit this whole information to the FDA or Ministry of Health, MOH, and we call it dossier. In that, we mention all the information we have collected during our phase 1, phase 2, phase 3 trial. And especially phase 1 trial. Because phase 1 trial will go, after that, it will go to Ministry of Health, and GRAB, we call it GRAB, Drug Regulatory Affairs, and they check the document about how is the result. Or in United States, it will go to FDA. And then if they will find this is safe drug, then they allow them for the phase 2 trial and then phase 3 trial. Once there is a success in the phase 3 trial over the 5,000 number of the patients in multiple hospitals, then they allow them to introduce the drug in the market, and we call it marketed medicine. Marketed medicine, marketed medicine assessment means what we have marketed already, we assess the drug and we find out that if any adverse effect will also during the launch of the drug in the market, commercial, then if we get more information about the side effects or adverse effects, then we withdraw that drug. We are not going to continue that drug in the market. So in that way, we provide better and safe drug to the patient, because we have concern for the health of the patient. The first priority what in subject clinical practice of clinical pharmacy, the first thing is we take care of the patient, and we have concerned more about the patient health. The patient health should be considered first, and then our commercial side for the profitability of the drug. Of course, each and every pharmaceutical company in the market is willing to earn more and more profit, but with no compromise with the health of a patient, with anything wrong with the patient. So we have to go through a certain process, and we call it evaluation of the drug. through the FDA, through our clinical trials, and it's a whole science that how can we provide a best drug to the patient through complete check and balance. So this is all about today.